Hi everyone, this is Joe here from thekissprinciple.net. Want to answer a short question here, and that is, okay, I want to learn praise and worship style piano. Where do I start? What kind of piano or keyboard do I need? What do I get? How much do I spend? It is quite a difficult one to answer because there are so many out there. Now, here in the music room where I am, I've got an upright acoustic piano that I like to play on, so that's quite nice. But I also use a smaller Yamaha digital piano style keyboard as well. And I practice on that in the evenings, so that way I don't wake anyone up or annoy anybody. So I usually have the volume turned down low on that, or I'll put the headphones on. So that's always a good one to do as well. So what do I do? Where do I start? I'll try and give you some guides that you can follow. The first thing is, spend what you are able to comfortably afford, okay? You don't need to spend thousands of dollars on a piano or a keyboard. Keyboards range a lot in styles and prices. You can get some from a few hundred to a few thousand. So if budget is a bit of an issue with you, only spend what you can comfortably afford. So have a look around, do your research, go shopping, ask plenty of questions. So that's the first bit of advice I would have. The second one is get one that has got at least 66 keys. Now, if you can get one that's got more than 66 keys, that's fantastic. But don't go any lower than 66, because then it starts to get just a little bit more difficult when you're doing particular left-hand exercises and drills, etc. So the more keys, the better, but I wouldn't go any lower than 66 keys. The third one I'd like to recommend is that if at all you're able to get weighted keys, then get it. Now, what's weighted keys on the keyboard? It just simply makes it feel like a real piano. So an acoustic piano like this one here, the keys feel heavier and a little bit more weighted, so you don't exactly press the a note accidentally. And keyboards that don't have the weighted keys, it's easier to accidentally press a key when you don't want to. It's not a necessity because you can get used to it. The keyboard that I have that I'll practice on late at night, that doesn't have weighted keys. It has a form of resistive keys that Yamaha have made, and it's still not too bad. But I've gotten accustomed to both, so I can work on an acoustic or I can work on the small keyboard there. So again, get it if you can, but if you can't, don't worry about it. The other one is make sure that if you're able to get one that's got external speakers. Some keyboards need you to plug into an external amp, so you have to buy another one of them as well. But if you've got internal speakers and they sound nice, get those ones. Don't worry so much about different kinds of accompaniment styles and patterns if they come with all those bells and whistles on it. They're not really that necessary. But if you've got it, okay, that's great, bonus. Also, get a sustain pedal. If the keyboard doesn't come with one, spend a little bit extra. I think it's probably about an extra $20 to $30 for a sustain pedal. The reason behind that is when you're learning piano or playing piano, using a sustain pedal will make all the difference between you sounding professional or a terrible beginner. So I'll be putting up some YouTube videos on the use of sustain pedal. But again, if it doesn't come with one, get a sustain pedal. Hope that's of some help for you. Don't forget to subscribe to us on this channel, thekissprinciple.net. Have a blessed day. God bless.